Greetings, everybody. We're here on the Steinhatchee River. It's a disaster area, to say the least. And about all the coastal towns, Horseshoe Beach, Steinhatchee, Keaton Beach, they got hit really hard. Not just with the wind damage, but with the storm surge. I'm not sure what the final conclusion was, but they were saying possibly up to a 15-foot storm surge. I wouldn't doubt that that's not what it were, because the restaurant over there, they say that it was just the roof's part of the roof sticking out of the water at the height of it. A lot of damage. Most of the docks were ripped away. Quite a few of the sailboats are gone. Many of them plowed into the bridge and were destroyed by when they went down the river into the Steinhatchee Bridge. So I guess this is the sort of the calm after the storm a little bit. We just thank the Lord. We're grateful that our two mission vessels survived. We have minor damage. Side scraped up some of the rub rail broken off, but not nothing major. We did lose all of our moorings. The moorings held fast. That's what saved the Gulf Star 50. A friend of mine, quite an eccentric individual. He was a treasure hunter, a sailor, and I don't know what else. Just he was an eccentric, what he was. But anyway, he's gone on now. But when he was alive, he had had somehow acquired a chain off of a United States Navy war vessel. I don't know if it was a destroyer or mine. I don't know what it was, but it was a huge chain and running across the Steinhatchee River from Taylor to Dixie County. Well, from my understanding, he got in a little trouble with the officials, so he had to drop it in the river. So that chain is literally laying across the bottom of the Steinhatchee River. Now, the moorings we have, one of the moorings we have was about a commercial saw blade about 3 inches thick and about 6 feet in diameter with a skidder axle welded up to the center of it. And it'd been laying on its side, so it'd been dragging. On top of that was about one dozen 100-pound truck hubs. And then we had another chain of truck hubs attached to all of that. Probably 3,000 pounds down there, I would guess, estimate, maybe more. So when 5 sailboats, a dock and a garbage dumpster all piled into the Gulf Star with all that weight, it all dragged until it got within 100 yards of the bridge, and then it just snagged. It held. It could have been a rock. It could have been Finley's old anchor chain from, I don't know, but it wouldn't move. And so the boat turned, and from what I understand, all them other boats that were piled up on the Gulf Star slipped off, and they went underneath the bridge and were demasted and destroyed. So that's what we know about it. Some of it's on video. And yesterday morning we was able to get the Gulf Star back up here in the anchorage. And also the Morgan 41, we have it on anchorage now as well. The mooring broke off of that one. And so now we have a stern mooring on each one of these vessels, but we're gonna have to fabricate and build some more moorings now. And then we have some really large claw anchors, or Bruce anchors, some call, holding the bow in place. So that's how we're securing our vessels right now until we can get some more moorings built and put down. Right now we're trying to coordinate to obtain materials we need, truck hubs, whatever that we can put together to make a good mooring. So we're working on that. It's going to take a little time to get everything coordinated and get all the materials that we need to make it happen. And then we'll figure out how to get it back out here. And so we just got a lot going on. And then back at the house, we got a wife and chickens and dogs and animals. And then we have a church that suffered a little damage, not a lot, not any structural damage, just a pavilion we had got destroyed and a lot of trees down over the cemetery behind the church. So we just got a lot to clean up and going on. It is a disaster area. We have been in hurricanes in time past in the islands. and we've seen what they can do. We've done a lot of hurricane and storm relief in the islands as well, and so we know what they're capable of. And from what I understand, I was told that this is the worst storm that has hit this part of Florida since they've ever began recording hurricanes. That's what we're told. Some of the old timers been around here their entire life, that's what they say, and others. So that's all I know. I do know it was bad enough, and we just praise God. There was no loss of life, nobody hurt that we're aware of. Loss of property, mainly. So we just got to clean up, rebuild, do what we got to do. On another note, I was just told a while ago that the President of the United States of America is here in Steinhatchee right now as I speak. I guess that's the reason why I've seen all them state patrol cruisers and all the law enforcement, strong arm of the Lord, across the river there in Steinhatchee. Because I'm here on the deck of the La Victoria right now, out in the middle of the river. Not in the middle of the river, but sort of on the Jenna side, but out over here on the anchorage. All right, everybody. I just thought I'd give you a little bit more of an update. We came back up here today to check on everything, and we had to run another line off the Morgan 41, and I feel a little bit better about that now. So we're going to go home and do something else. God bless you. We appreciate all your prayers, your praying. And I do feel real bad about those that have lost property and all that. But the Lord will help us, and we will rebuild by the help of the Lord. And it's all in His hands anyhow. We appreciate your praying. We appreciate everybody that's had a hand and still do and have a heart to give a helping hand. And we'll talk to you all later. God bless you.